Welcome to Las Vegas for the most lucrative tournament in bowling history. With a million-dollar purse, these PBA pros aren't exactly bowling for soup today.
It has always been special, the PBA's signature event, the Tournament of Champions. And today, the TOC becomes even more significant with $1 million in prize money. The richest purse in the history of the sport. Your number one seed, Tom Smallwood, has gone from unemployed auto worker to PBA champion. Now, he's one match away from $250,000 payday.
Bringing you competition among the greatest bowlers in the world. This ABC Sports Telecast is brought to you by the PBA. Hi and welcome. I'm Nelson Burton, and for more than three decades, my partner Chris Schenkel used that message to welcome all of you to the Pro Bowlers Tour on ABC. And the PBA is back on the network, and back bigger than ever with the $1 million Tournament of Champions. Now, I had a chance to call the action in many a Tournament of Champions, and I used to call it this way. It's the toughest and the easiest tournament to win. The toughest had a lot of money. It was a major tournament. It was the easiest tournament because there was only 48-man field. But now I have to change that moniker just a little bit. It is the toughest tournament to win, and it's the toughest tournament to win. It's double tough. $1 million, all the great players, and what makes it double tough, instead of a limited 48-man field, the PBA opened it up to all the champions. 175 players went to the starting gate 6 days ago. We are down to the final four players who are bowling for $250,000 and this wonderful trophy, and we will have that first shot in just a moment. Now, throughout the show, I will be back to chronicle some of my favorite moments in the Tournament of Champions and a little segment on my partner, Chris Schenkel. And now it's time to turn it over to the PBA announcers, Hall of Famer Randy Peterson and the brilliant Rob Stone. Guys?
You know, being called brilliant never gets old. Randy, Rob, back here with you. And we begin with a return to probably the most compelling storyline the PBA has really ever witnessed. Tom Smallwood, former unemployed Michigan auto worker, turned PBA pro, turned PBA world champion, and now here's Smallwood sitting on the cusp of a $250,000 payday, Randy.
Well, Rob, you know, he told us last night that he's a nervous bowler. Well, I'll give him 250,000 reasons to be nervous today. But his exterior seems to be anything but uneasy. He was cyborg-like at last year's World Championship, taking down reigning Player of the Year Wes Mallott en route to his first-ever title. Rob, he said he does his best bowling when he's anxious, this being the richest tournament in bowling history. He may just be unbeatable today.
Yeah, and for the first time on television, Smallwood is a number one seed. Tampa, Florida's Tom Daugherty is your from out of nowhere to number two seed story.
Yeah, Tom Daugherty, a power player. He doesn't use his thumb, but it's his first time ever on television. He'll need to find a way to handle the nerves.
Three seed Mika Koivuniemi was third last year here at the TOC.
Major Mika hasn't won a major in 10 years. Today, he needs to find a way to beat power with finesse.
And four seed Andres Gomez trying to become the first Colombian to win a PBA event.
The smooth stroker from Bogota, Colombia. He has a second-place finish already this season. He'll need to draw on that experience.
So it's an all-international first match. Finland's Mika Koivuniemi, Gomez from Colombia. They are joined down laneside by Kimberly Pressler.
Rob, the power players reign supreme this week, but Mika, you are not a power player. How did you make it into the Final Four?
I've been throwing really good whole week, and I need to do one more hour the same thing, so refs were not my favorite this week, but I think I was more accurate than anybody else.
And Andreas, you recently got second in the Pepsi Viper Championship against Bill O'Neill. What did you learn from that experience?
Well, I learned that I feel actually pretty comfortable on TV, so I'm just going to do my game and hopefully get some strikes.
Rob, it looks like these two international players are ready to make their mark on the TOC.
Thank you, Kimberly. And the 46th edition of the PBA Tournament of Champions features the richest purse in PBA history. $250,000 winner's check to our titleist. A cool $100,000 to the runner-up. $50,000 for third and $40,000 for fourth. Time now for the introductions for match number one.
The number four qualifier is an exempt player and three-time South American Championship winner representing Colombia, Andres Gomez.
Best major finish till now, of course, was 13th at the 2001 U.S. Open, trying to become just the second Latin American to win on the PBA Tour.
The first being Amleto Monicelli. And Rob, today, for these four players in this setting, the biggest tournament in the history of bowling, it's all about trying to handle the nerves. This shot goes high, and I promise you, the 3-6-9-10 is not a spare you want to shoot at. Problem being the back pin, the 9 pin. Very easy to chop this spare.
Gomez cleans it up nicely. Spare in the first. He takes a seat. Here's the intro for our number three seed.
The number three qualifier is an eight-time PBA Tour champion with two major titles representing Finland. Major Mika Koivuniemi.
Koivuniemi with a couple solid nicknames. Major Mika, his first two wins on the PBA Tour were at majors, also known as the Big Finn, 6'4", 185, originally from Finland, now lives in Michigan. And a 7-10 split to chew on in his first frame. Now, Gomez dropped the 7-10 yesterday during qualifying.
Yeah, and this is just a horrible break. Both the 7 and the 10 get nudged. Neither one go down. Unless Mika can convert the 7-10 split, which has only been done three times in the history of television, he's going to look at an open frame early on.
Mika takes down the 10, leads the 7. We say this every week, though, Randy. If you're going to have an open frame, you want it in the first.
Well, and that was a really good shot that Mika threw right there, starting with a mission domination. You can see the hook potential there, along with the taboo and the world beater, the strongest equipment in his arsenal. But again, you know, I always talk about the 7-10 being the worst break in bowling because it's a really good shot, pocket shot, and you don't leave the 7 or the 10, you leave both, and it's an open frame.
We are still without a strike here. Koivuniemi making back-to-back TOC shows, was third last year. He lost to eventual champion Kelly Kulik, who became the first female to ever win on the PBA Tour last year right here at Red Rock.
And Mika really had a chance to help his tour roommate out, Chris Barnes, who just missed the telecast. Mika had to beat Andres Gomez in position round. Failed to do so. Chris Barnes shot 270 last game, but came up short.
So a slow start for the Big Finn. Open frame spare, and he gives way now to the Colombian, Andres Gomez, who originally came to the United States to study at the University of Florida. His hope was to bowl there. They didn't have a team, so he moved on to the University of Central Florida in Orlando. They also did not have a team, but he eventually graduated there from the degree in business administration as a member of Team Colombia, which does help support his bowling career. Seven pin nudge, but will not drop. And again, we remain strikeless.
Well, a lot of pressure in this major championship. All of the money. But I'll tell you, Rob, I've said it before, I'll say it again, pressure is what makes sports fun. Without pressure, well, it would just be another game, wouldn't it?
And he whiffs the seven pin.
And again, it's going to show itself all day today. Capital P. The player that can control their their mental outlook, their mental frame of mind. Stay focused, not think about all the intangibles. That'll be the player that comes out on top.
Gomez telling us yesterday, the whole week, the goal for me was not to think about the money. Just focus on the bowling. If not, I'm in trouble. There's Gomez's arsenal as he steps up in the third.
And finally, a strike on this very challenging oil pattern. We'll get more into that in our next segment.
And going with it too fast, Rob, because it's very angular down the lane. And that's what you've seen throughout this week. Again, a huge advantage to power players because they can move in and get their bowling balls to read off the end of the pattern because of the high rev rate. Gomez and Mika, however, don't really fall into that category.
Both kind of tweeners.
Yes.
Finds the pocket there to Koivuniemi. So both guys struggling in the first two frames. Looks like they may have figured things out slightly here in the third. Let's see if there's a carryover in the fourth.
Well, right now, after three frames, they're actually starting to breathe oxygen.
That $250,000 winner's check can suffocate a lot of people.
Back-to-back jacks for the big spin.
Boy, he had to really put a good touch on that shot. This ball is a little wide out of Mika's hand. The big fin, big tall guy, not a lot of knee bend, but he makes up with it with upper body lean. But the good touch results in that ball getting into the swish zone, and it's a double for Mika.
Gomez trying to match Mika with a double of his own.
And he does. Well, you can really sense that both of these guys have kind of decompressed and calmed down finally.
And Rob, when you're talking about both players being tweeners, they are in terms of rev rate. But Andres plays the lanes completely different. He's got slower speed, and he's got a lot more side rotation, which allows him to move in and play a much deeper angle. Mika can play that, but he likes to go with his bread and butter, which is staying on top of it, going straighter, getting the loft involved, and throwing that nice, straight, tight line to the pocket.
Gomez was never out of the top 15 in qualifying this week. Member of Team Columbia steps up to open the fifth.
So a triple for Gomez now after the early struggles.
Both players with opens early. Now they're starting to get settled in. This is just a great shot. The only pin that could have stood there was possibly a solid seven. Mika now finds himself down by nine, but with a strike here in the fifth frame, can regain the lead by one.
It's been a decade since the last major title for Koivuniemi and 3.5 years since his last PBA title.
Three in a row for Mika and Gomez.
When asking him what happened last week against Mike Logan Jr., he lost by one pin. He needed to fill 19 pins in the 10th frame to advance. He went seven, spare nine to lose by one. He said, yeah, you know what? I was real upset about it. Lasted for about a day, but you have to put it behind you and move forward. Obviously a testament to the great skills of Mika Koivuniemi. He's back here again.
A major ham bone for Major Mika. Koivuniemi and Gomez trying to move one step closer to $250,000 payday. Their match concludes when we return to Las Vegas.
The PBA Tournament of Champions on ABC. Brought to you by the makers of One-A-Day Men's 50-Plus Advantage. The multivitamin with more of what matters. Just for Men for mustache and beard. keep your edge. The USBC and its 2 million members. To find out more about USBC, log on to bull.com today. And Lumber Liquidators, hardwood flooring for less.
We welcome you to a sold-out Red Rock Lanes and the 46th edition of the PBA Tournament of Champions. We're through 5.5 frames of match number one. Time now for the Lumber Liquidators Know the Wood segment with Randy.
The 39-foot Tournament of Champions pattern has the most concentration of oil here in the middle part of the lane, signified by this dark blue color. This is where you're going to see the majority of the action. Now, anytime you see an oil pattern like this, it forces the players to play the deep inside line, and that will always favor the power player because they can move in, create angle, and all of that power creates a tremendous amount of pin carry.
It also allows for a decent scoring pace. There were 200-300 games this week through qualifying. Jason Belmonte and Doug Kent ratcheting up those. Mika Koivuniemi started with an open frame, then went spare. Since then, he dropped a four-bagger. Now it's Gomez's turn, the Colombian, his turn to try and equal Koivuniemi's four-bagger. A Colombian ham bone for Gomez.
And after a rocky start, Rock, the players have now found their rhythm, each with two four-baggers.
And here's Andres on what a win today would mean to him.
It means everything. It means all the hard work, all the years of bowling, you know, traveling, learning, waking up early to practice, staying late to practice. You know, it means everything. It's a really good feeling that, you know, after so much hard work, I'm able to get to this TV show.
And he's now dropped a nickel. Five in a row for Gomez.
Just puts a great touch on this. You see the ball cross the middle arrow. Remember, you saw it in the oil pattern, the players playing the deep inside line. Well, Andres Gomez is showing you that he loves it in there. Mika considerably farther to the right, going with his strength. Both players locked in.
Koivuniemi down nine to close out the seventh. Leaves the 3-6-10.
Mika gets too much of this ball right here at the bottom of the swing. Watch this, a little bit extra loft, and when he lofts up, he tends to grab and hit up on it. That made the ball hook early and not hold its line.
Flex spare conversion. Head on over to PBA.com during today's telecast to submit your More of What Matters to You fan question, brought to you by the makers of One A Day. Today's question can be directed to Bo Burton. If your question is selected, you will be recognized on air, and your question will be answered by Bo a little bit later in our telecast. Great to have Bo on the broadcast.
It is. Oh, it really is. Sure brings back a lot of memories for me, especially.
We begin the eighth with Mika Koivuniemi off that spare. Back on the strike train is the Big Fin.
Now that shot there, much more level to the lane.
Lena, Mika's wife, looking on.
Now watch this. I want you to watch the launch angle right here. Notice how that ball's more flat, more level to the lane as he lets go of it. That way the ball is able to hold its line. Something to watch for with Mika. Watch for excessive loft.
And yeah! Gomez cracks open a six-pack. It's
Don't miss all of ESPN's pregame and postgame analysis surrounding tomorrow's AFC and NFC Conference Championship games. NFL countdown tomorrow, 1 Eastern, for your pregame work. Then catch all the postgame analysis and look ahead to Super Bowl 45 on NFL Primetime, 10:30 p.m. Eastern. Sunday NFL countdown presented by IBM. NFL Primetime presented by E-Trade on Sunday. We begin the foundation frame ninth. Gomez on top.
Whoa. Well, he was in cruise control, and he knew it as soon as he let go, and he needed to catch a break. He did not. 3-4-6-7 split.
How do you attack this?
You get the ball to the right side of the three-pin, throw it over into the 4-7. The ball covers a 6. As you take a look at that side roll, but notice how it hit the 10th board, that dark board down there, that rangefinder. It needs to get right of that for him to have any chance of holding line.
Gomez had an open frame in the second. And an open frame in the ninth. A major window has just been pulled open for that man, Mika Koivuniemi.
And this is what champions are made of, and this is what major champions are made of. Mika's going to take a re-rack. He is not going to let anything affect this next shot. He wants to collect himself and throw the best shot he can throw. If he strikes out, he shoots 246. He will shut out Andres Gomez. The best Andres Gomez can shoot, 230.
Take a look at some of the other finishers, including the prize money and Chris Barnes just missing out on the TV show, finishing fifth. He won last week in the first major of the season, the PBA World Championship here in Vegas. Oscu Palermo had a wonderful tournament, finishing seventh. There's Sean Rash in eighth, and the real deal, Bill O'Neill in ninth. Koivuniemi in the ninth.
Beautiful, beautiful shot. How about my guy Mike Edwards finishing 11th, making 21 grand?
Mike Edwards, our longtime stat man, right here on my right hip right now. We don't play favorites, but we were quietly cheering for Mike throughout the week. Machugs finishing 15th. Stormman, Norman, Norm Duke finishing 16th. You're going to see Norm Duke Super Bowl Sunday in a great event on ESPN, the Chris Paul PBA Celebrity Event. Nelly, Lil Wayne, Reggie Bush were there. Mike Scroggins, our friend Scroggy, finishing 19th. And Maximum Bob, Robert Smith, at 20th.
Mika took a re-rack in the ninth. He took another re-rack in the 10th. He's out of re-racks. The players are allowed 2 per game. A lot of things going on right now. Mika taking his time. He's also making his opponent sit an awful long time. But here's the deal. A strike here is in the high 230s. With any good count, this will win it for Mika.
Messenger,
hang on,
missing the 10.
Now, Mika converts here, and any good count, he will be in the mid-220s. That will force Andres Gomez to get 2 and good count.
I don't speak Finnish.
That means carry.
Carry. Okay, thank you. Drops to 10.
Well, that was an impressive shot. And for the money, he knew it was on the line. He needed that first strike in the 10th to shut out Andres Gomez, only to leave a 10-pin. Now, he needs at least 6 to force Andres to get 2 in the 10th. If Andres goes strike spare or spare strike in the 10th frame, he will only shoot 220. That's enough. Andres Gomez needs 2 and 5 to move on.
So Koivuniemi in the books with a 224. He will sit and watch the Colombian, Andres Gomez.
Remember last week it was a 10-pin. That was the undoing of Mika Koivuniemi to lose to Michael Haugen by 1. It was a 10-pin, his first shot here. Let's see if Andres Gomez can show all of his Colombian moxie and man up with 2 big strikes right here.
Again, this just the second ever televised appearance for Andres Gomez. Was the number 1 seed earlier this season at the Pepsi Viper Championship, lost in the title match to Bill O'Neill. Mika Koivuniemi, of our four finalists, clearly has the most experience.
This is a problem, potentially. He's been sitting a long time. Remember, Mika took two re-racks. Now he's having a problem with a pin resetting on the left lane. It's been a while for Andres since he threw the last shot. And rhythm, well, it's all about rhythm right now.
Mandatory strike here in the 10th.
Beautiful shot from Gomez. He'll need another one.
We saw him last night, the position round match against Mika Koivuniemi. He was unflappable. Bowled one of his best games of the tournament to beat Mika and secure his spot here today. He needs one more, just like the last one he threw.
Gomez beat Koivuniemi in both of their meetings this week in round robin match play. Now trying to do it under the lights. Another mandatory strike here for Gomez. And then he's in great shape to move on.
Wide right.
And the seven will drop, and Koivuniemi moves on.
Well, Mika catches one, a break that is, for a change. And you can see the disappointment in Andres Gomez's face. He knew it was wide right out of his hand.
Lena and Mika celebrate. When our live coverage of the TOC resumes, Bo Burton returns with a TOC reflection.
So Mika Koivuniemi, four pins better than Andres Gomez, and the Big Finn moves on to the semifinal. Take on Mr. Daugherty from Tampa, Florida. Today, we take a look back at the 1967 Tournament of Champions for our Just for Men Mustache and Beard Keep Your Edge moment.
Here is a $10,000 ball. Let's watch this ball close.
That 300 game happened at the 1967 TOC. Rob Stone, Bo Burton back here with you. You know plenty about TOCs, Bo. Tell me your favorite TOC moment. I know there's a lot of them.
Well, I had a lot of them, but that is one of them with Jack Biondolillo there. That was the holy grail of bowling. Bowling 300 was the four-minute mile back then. And I sat in a hotel room and watched him throw that game. I couldn't believe it. It set everybody's goals higher. But some of the other moments that I really, really like, or say Marshall Holman had a great moment. I think we'll have a piece on him. Billy Hardwick, Dave Davis, Barry Asher, all great players. Back then in black and white, it was fun.
Marshall Holman with a big win at the TOC that you say really kind of kicked his career into high gear.
Yeah, Marshall Holman was the new guy on the block. He was the guy that filled in the big three. There was Earl Anthony came along, and then Mark Roth came along, and here's the guy that we love to have on television, Rob. You never knew what Marshall was going to do. One of the greatest talents that ever stood on a bowling lanes, but he could do anything. He went in a slump at one time. He lost 15 straight matches in the championship round, and boy, was that fun to call the action on those.
Yeah, he won that TOC in 1976, won his second 10 years later, one of only a handful to win multiple TOC titles. And again, we're at the TOC. We talk about the TOC. The TOC means so much more to you than just great moments, also great times with your former partner.
Well, Chris Schenkel, as you well know, was my partner for better than 2.5 decades, and he was just a great guy all the time. He was this gentleman, and you know what? He really knew bowling, Rob. A lot of people accuse Chris of saying, well, you're just standing there, and like, you know bowling. And what Chris would do, he would use his color analyst to the maximum. And he was great at that. And there's a cute story real quick. Every once in a while, he'd get a weird leave like you just had in the match. Let's say the 1-2-4, 6-10. And he'd look at me and he'd say, Bo, that's an ugly cluster down there. What do you have to do? And I'd say, Chris, Well, you got to throw the ugly cluster shot. And he really knew his bowling, and he was great, and he was the voice of professional bowling.
The ugly cluster. I'm going to have to use that. Hopefully we won't see one in the next segment. And by the way, I love the blazer. And the there it is, the ABC Sports logo. Going old school on us, Bo.
1975.
It doesn't show. It wears well. Bo will be back with us a little bit later in the broadcast. And when we return, Tom Daugherty from Tampa, Florida, gets set to make his TV debut. You'll witness it after this message and a word from our ABC stations. Rob Stone, Randy Peterson, Kimberly Pressler, and the incomparable Bo Burton welcoming you back to ABC's live coverage of the Tournament of Champions coming away from Red Rock Lanes here in Las Vegas, Nevada. Mika Koivuniemi lives to bowl another match, the three seed, four pins better than Andres Gomez. Up now, your semifinal showdown with Tom Daugherty. A wonderful from nowhere story is Tom Daugherty. We'll get into that in just a moment, but Mika Koivuniemi will bat leadoff here in our semifinal match as the big Finn steps up on the left lane.
The number two qualifier is a four-time PBA regional champion from Wesley Chapel, Florida, TD, Tom Daugherty.
Daugherty had to bowl 72 games over 6 days just to get here on television, by far more than any of our four finalists. And leaves the 2-8-10 out of the gate.
And talk about being welcome to television for the first time ever. You see Tom Daugherty doesn't use his thumb. There's a thumb there on the side of the bowling ball. Very first shot, 2-8-10.
The first event of the season for him and his first television show. A big cleanup effort here, and he'll go open frame in the first. And if we've learned anything, an open frame in the first does not spell complete disaster. Koivuniemi had an open frame in the first frame in his last match as we take a look at Tom Daugherty's arsenal today.
Going with a nomad dagger, not the hookingest ball in that line or in his arsenal, but that's what he brought today. Reason being, he's got a rev rate of probably close to 600. A lot of RPMs coming out of this hand right here.
Yeah! And the first televised strike for Tom Daugherty. A big crowd at Royal Lanes in Lutz, Florida, cheering him on right now. And he and Patrick Allen have a pro shop there, and a big crowd in Tampa watching Tom Daugherty today.
Well, I'll tell you what, if Tom Daugherty gets it going, he's a lot of fun to watch. Very animated. Right now, he's just got to figure out a way to keep his emotions in check. This man knows how to do it.
Back to back, opening jacks in the semifinal match for Mika. Coming your way, Super Bowl Sunday, 4 p.m. Eastern. It's the third installment of the Chris Paul PBA Celebrity Invitational. And I'm going to go on a limb, Randy, and say it was probably the most enjoyable Chris Paul PBA Celebrity Invitation we've had, and we've had some good ones. Lil Wayne was there, Nelly, Reggie Bush. Nelly in the booth with us? Priceless.
Yeah, but why did they have to show Lil Wayne throwing it in the gutter? I mean, that's there's no love
that,
there.
That is disrespectful to Lil Wayne.
Opening three-bagger for Mika Koivuniemi.
Wife applauds. Again, it's Koivuniemi, by far the most experienced of the four bowlers on today's TV show, and he is up 31 early on Tom Daugherty. The big four is a big problem now for Daugherty.
Well, remember, he went light in the first frame, made an adjustment, and goes right through the nose. As you can take a look at that backswing there, he's got a full cup wrist, no thumbing it. He liked that shot. You saw him running it out early. The Big Four only made once on television. That's by Walter Ray Williams Jr. But right now, he's got a mountain to climb.
Stay aggressive. A huge early hole for Daugherty. Down 45, there's his wife, Kristen, looking on. Kristen and Tom, proud parents of an eight-month-old girl, Cameron. Tom, also his son, Cody, watching as well back home.
And again, Rob, the only problem with excessive rev rate
that was a bad shot.
Is when the lanes are flat like this and you can't cure shots off your hand, a little left or a little right is disastrous. 2-8-10 in the first frame when he got it wide. Nice shot in the second. Through the nose in the third for the Big Four. Right now, Tom Daugherty struggling to find rhythm.
Oh, no. The crowd trying to pick him back up, but this is a massive hole he has dug himself. He needs Mika Koivuniemi to make some major errors if he's going to get himself back in this.
And I just don't see that happening. Mika is a seasoned veteran, a major champion. He's been in this situation before.
An opening four-bagger here in the semifinal match for Koivuniemi. He is in absolute cruise control right now. ESPN, the home court of college hoops. Two of the preseason favorites in the Big Ten hook up on Saturday primetime. Juwan Johnson and Purdue. And on Darrell Summers and the Spartans of Michigan State. Saturday primetime presented by DirecTV on ESPN tonight at 9 Eastern. Coverage begins with College Game Day, driven by State Farm at 8 Eastern. That game also available online at ESPN3.com and on your phone. Koivuniemi trying to start with a perfect set of five strikes.
And he does. Right now, Mika's got his eye on the trophy. He says, I'm going to put away Tom Daugherty, and then I'm going to have a go at Tom Smallwood for the title. Through five frames, he is not going to let up. He is a champion. And when he gets an advantage from his opponent, he's going to take advantage.
All right.
Well, I promise you, this wasn't the ball reaction he had to get him to this point. I remember watching last night in position round.
Are you kidding me?
With Nelson Burton Jr. sitting right next to me and Tom Daugherty. Well, he beat Tom Smallwood in position round and came back to us and said that was the greatest game he's ever bowled in his life.
All right, I got 50.
He averaged a 225.26 this week, highest of our four finalists. He's not displaying it right now. He's displaying a good attitude, but obviously a disappointing outcome for him thus far. Three open frames in his first five.
Well, Tom, welcome to live television and a major championship. And sometimes it can be cruel.
Yeah, this is more like cruel and unusual punishment. But Mika Koivuniemi in the background, stoic look.
I guess that's what I get for breaking up every split this week.
His face has not changed. He is focused and dialed in and will not take his foot off of Daugherty's throat. Another open frame for Tom. He will take a seat, and Mika Koivuniemi, perfect through five, is that much closer to a title match showdown with Tom Smallwood and a quarter of a million dollar payday. We're back to Vegas after this.
The PBA Tournament of Champions on ABC, brought to you by GEICO. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance. Vice Inserts, the choice of champions. It doesn't get any better. Brunswick, find your next ball at bowlwithbrunswick.com. And Barbasol, start your day with Barbasol shaving cream.
We welcome you back to Las Vegas. Dennis Matthews, the bowling operations manager here at Red Rocks Lane, there on your right. To his right and our left, that was Fred Schreier, the PBA commissioner and CEO. Thanks to Dennis and Fred and everybody involved in putting on this wonderful event here. Again, this is the 46th edition of the PBA Tournament of Champions, the second major of the season. The first was last weekend, won by Chris Barnes, the PBA World Championship. Now Mika Koivuniemi closing in on a title match showdown with number one seed Tom Smallwood. Mika up 101 pins. Here he closes out the sixth. Perfection continues for Mika.
Well, he followed the game plan to perfection thus far, Rob, and that's straighter is greater. That's his A game. He's going with loft. He's going nice and straight and direct. But you know what? When asked last night why he had success this week when it looked like it was a power players tournament, he said, simple. I just made great shots.
He was on last week's PBA World Championship show. Was the fifth seed, finished sixth. And another strike. So seven in a row for Mika. And when we talked to him last week, he was confident. On the verge of maybe being a little cocky, a little too confident. We talked to him yesterday, and his sense it was dialed down just a little bit, enough to know that he was comfortable with his game and where he was, but some of that edge had left. Tom Daugherty here in the seventh, picking up the pace and getting a strike. His second on TV, and exhale. Now we take a look at the Bear Trusted Pain Relief Replay, brought to you by the makers of Bear Aspirin, and a much-needed relief for Daugherty getting a strike here in the seventh.
Well, Tommy's had a nice run in this event. Remember, he had to bowl 72 games. He qualified for this event by being a regional winner. Andres Gomez qualified for this event because he is a current exempt player. Only Gomez and Stuart Williams of England were the only two non-champions in this entire field. This is turning into a nightmare for Tom Daugherty.
Yeah, the beauty of it, though, is he has such a great personality.
Now I'm relaxed again.
Now you relax a little bit? Mika say, now I can sit back and enjoy. And Daugherty, just one of the real, real good people out here. You and I have known him for a while. We also want to send on a quick get-well message to his father-in-law, Craig McGuire. Was in a really bad accident Thursday morning in Florida. Was life-flighted out. Was in the hospital last night. Looks like everything's going to be all right with Craig, and we wish him a speedy recovery.
Gotta get to 100. Gotta get to 100.
Yeah, he needs two marks to break 100. It'll be the lowest game in Tournament of Champions history.
126? Sure, he'll.
And he
love
needs
you mentioning that.
Well, you know, I'm just stating facts, sir. The lowest game ever bowled on television, 126. He's got his work cut out for him.
Here's Mika, perfect through seven. His effort in the eighth. I'm not going to say anything. I'm not going to talk about it. It has been nothing but strikes for Koivuniemi in the semis.
Well, the biggest lopsided game in Tournament of Champions history. 20 perfect games bowled on TV. The last one being Rhino Page, 2009, Tokyo, Japan.
In the Japan Cup.
Prior to that, it was here in the States, Ryan Schaefer in Indianapolis.
Perfection continues for the Big Fin.
And who can forget Mika Koivuniemi, December 7th, 2003, Windsor Locks, Connecticut. He bowled a perfect game against Jason Couch.
The 17th perfect game in PBA history. See Tom Daugherty stepping up and firing as a class move. He is trying to get out of the way and let Mika and his pursuit of a perfect game in history get going. And we really don't want to rush
Tom off stage, but I think he would like to get off stage as quick as he can. Almost a great pickup.
Get up, fire off, get the 10th frame out of your way, and step aside for that man, Mika Koivuniemi.
Perfect. I mean, really? Again?
All right, I need two.
Two for 100.
Come on, Tom. Come on, Tom.
Tom, don't do it.
They're not booing. They're chanting two. You got to love it.
Unbelievable.
I mean, these are numbers.
Oh, man, you got to feel for
these are numbers my wife would put up at the bowling center.
Got
Here we
feel
go.
For
I need two, baby, two.
Come on, Tom. We're cheering for you, bud.
Yeah!
Yeah! Yeah!
Give him 100!
Woo!
Oh, glory. Right. Get it and live it up, son.
Yeah! All right. Hey, we got some business over here.
True that. So Daugherty with 100 sits down. Koivuniemi trying to pull out a 300. And a smile finally cracks the face of Koivuniemi. Again, only 20 times on television has a 300 game been rolled. Only 4 times at a major. He is 3 strikes away from a perfect game.
Two strikes away from perfection. Mika Koivuniemi is got his sights on a major championship. Standing in the way. Possible perfection. What a game plan he came in with today.
Two strikes away from a $10,000 bonus check for dropping a 300 game on television.
Nobody's ever done it twice on TV.
Yeah! One more to go! Come on, Mika! Come on, Vegas! Get up!
Well, he actually pulled that one a bit, Rob, and I think he's a bit surprised that it held line.
He did not like it on the release, but the result will work just fine.
He's going to take a re-rack and regroup. And normally when you see somebody get away with one in the 10th or the 11th shot, 300 is right around the corner because that's the break they needed. He's going to be nice and relaxed. I'm going to go out on a limb and say he's going to throw this one really good. Come on, Mika.
He's already moved on to our title match and crack at a quarter of a $1 million payday. Now he's attacking history. Trying to become just the second person to throw a 300 game at the Tournament of Champions. For perfection! Come on, Messenger! Come on!
Reminiscent of Don Johnson's 299. You see Mika hit the turn. Jack Beyond the Little's record is safe. The only 300 game ever bowled back in 1967 at the Tournament of Champions.
Now Mika has to regroup and refocus on the real task at hand. A $250,000 payday by winning the TOC. Here's his last shot.
Got it in the oil just a little bit. The ball finishes just a bit soft. Messenger comes over only to be denied.
Wow. Grammy nominated Bowling Pursuit takes the stage with a live performance when our presentation of the richest bowling tournament in history returns.
Welcome back to the 2011 Tournament of Champions at the Red Rock Hotel and Casino in Las Vegas. Please welcome Grammy-nominated Bowling Pursuit.
New album, Fishing for Woos, available April 29th. Thank you, Bowling for Soup. Your number one seed, Tom Smallwood, continues his preps for his quest for his second major title of his young career. You'll see it after this message and a word from our ABC stations. ABC welcomes you back to our continuing live coverage of the Tournament of Champions, coming your way from the Red Rock Casino and Bowling Center here in Las Vegas, Nevada. Randy Peterson, Rob Stone, and Bo Burton rejoining us. And Bowling for Soup goes live. And before that, a 299 by Mika Koivuniemi. Let's all catch our breath. Let's relax. And a nice little segue here. It's time now for our More of What Matters to You fan question of the day, brought to you by the makers of One Today. It's directed to you, Bo. Randy, you have the question.
Bo, here is the answer to that question, which comes from Jared Motor of Coldwater, Ohio. Jared wants to know, what's the biggest difference between the players now and the players back when you were doing the broadcasting?
Well, I think the biggest difference, Randy, is maybe threefold. One is the scoring environment. You know, a 220 average used to win tournaments days before, but out on the tour, it's still tough to do it. But the huge difference is wood lanes to synthetics, and then you add in the final ingredient, and that's the rubber plastic balls, the transition to the urethane power balls we have today, which open up the pocket. And so, really, if you watch an old-time bowler, and you were a wood bowler, Mika has that style. He's using the old style. So you got the old against the new going in Smallwood.
Did you just call Randy an old-time bowler?
He's going to the Hall of Fame.
He'll be a Hall of Famer tonight. When we return, our title match, uninterrupted, life-changing money on the line. $250,000 will go to one of these two men, Mika Koivuniemi versus Tom Smallwood, for the title of TOC champion.
Rob Stone, Randy Peterson, Kimberly Pressler, Bo Burton, welcoming you back to our continuing live coverage of the Tournament of Champions, the second major of the PBA season. Time now for our Geico Championship recap. Randall.
Thanks, Rob. Match number one. We had a good one. Andres Gomez, Mika Koivuniemi. This one came down to the 10th frame. Andres needed two in the 10th. He got the first one, left the shaker seven. Mika advances. Head in match number two. Mika Koivuniemi taking on Tom Daugherty. He's perfect through nine. That's the first one in the 10th. The second one in the 10th was good. That's the third one, only to leave the messenger that wouldn't be answered. Mika Koivuniemi, 299 over Tom Doherty's 100.
Very interesting to see how Koivuniemi reacts coming off that 299 game, and he will start off our title match. Again, uninterrupted. $250,000 on the line here for the second major of the PBA season.
Both players having bowled 58 games in the tournament proper just to get to this point. Let's see if Mika can regroup from the 299 game against Gordon.
And he leaves a tentative, and it's almost ironic to say how he regroups. I mean, he shot almost a perfect game, but that last shot, such a mental and really a physical letdown, too. Just how much energy he put into that match.
Well, it's the emotional highs and lows. Mm-hmm. It's, you know, it's going from being on top of the world 1 second to falling off the very next second. Trying to regulate the up and downs. Mika is a veteran. He's been here before. He knows how to handle it.
The tournament leader won the 2009 PBA World Championship for his first PBA Tour title from Saginaw, Michigan, Tom Smallwood.
And folks, if you can't cheer for this guy and his story, you need to check yourself in somewhere. Former unemployed auto worker, laid off by GM a couple years ago, told his wife, give me a few months and let me try and earn a spot here on the PBA Tour. He did just that. He won the PBA World Championship last year for his first ever title.
That's bad.
And here he is trying to take home $250,000 at the TOC.
Take a look at Tom Smallwood cradling that ball there at the top of the swing. He does use his thumb, but he doesn't use all of it. About half of his thumb goes in the bowling ball. He rolls that ball up on his wrist, and that's what creates all of that revolution and power. Interesting to start. He is trying to mirror Mika Koivuniemi in terms of where they're playing on the lane.
And the skinny jeans don't fit. He misses the 10-pin open frame in the first of our title match. Cannot have mental errors like that.
Well, we talked about it in the open, Rob, how Tom Smallwood bowls nervous. He somehow finds a way to regulate that. You could see early on, with so much riding on this match, that the money, the prestige, Tom Smallwood also trying to prove to people that he's no flash in the pan, as you can see, using a very non-aggressive ball, the Mike Albee MVP.
Right through the nose on the left lane.
And the reason why he's using such a weak piece of equipment is so that he can try to play closer to where Mika's playing. If you see a player shoot 299, even though he doesn't throw it the same as you, you still try to somehow get in the same zone. And the only way he can do that is by using a ball that's not very aggressive.
Picks up that spare. So open frame spare to start for your number one seat. Tom Smallwood's parents here in attendance, Denny and Sharon, making the trip here to Vegas to watch their son. How proud they must be. But now they have to watch the big Finn, Mika Koivuniemi, a spare in the first. Dropped a 299 in the semifinal victory.
See, he likes both lanes equally the same.
Here he is on the right.
And his first strike of the title match.
Hey, Rob, I got to be honest. If you're Mika Koivuniemi watching Tom Smallwood's first two shots, knowing what your reaction looks like, Mika Koivuniemi right now is really liking the position he's in. He's got a great shot to the pocket. Tom Smallwood has yet to prove he does. And Mika's blueprint right now is perfect.
This will be Mika's best ever TOC finish. He finished third at last year's TOC here at Red Rock Lanes and Casino in Vegas. Very carry, got it.
Oh, absolutely. Yeah, you're learning finish real quick.
I'm a quick study, my friend. Back-to-back jacks for Mika.
You're good with language.
So Smallwood, open frame, spare. Here's his effort in the bottom of the third. Again, we will be with you through the conclusion of our title match. $250,000, the richest winning prize in PBA history to go to one of these two men.
First strike for Smallwood.
Tom Smallwood made it to this point by virtue of an absolutely unbelievable Friday all day. He went 8-0 in the morning, and then he only lost two matches Friday night, 14-2 in match play.
19-5 overall in match play. His best TOC finish was 37th last year. He's won only one title, but it was a big one, the 2009 World Championship in Wichita.
Back-to-back jacks for Smallwood.
I'll tell you what, Tom Smallwood showing a lot of maple moxie. He's not going to go anywhere. He said, you know what, I had a little stumble there to start, open frame early, but guess what? I'm a major championship winner, and I'm out to prove to everyone that it was no fluke.
Here's Mika Koivuniemi in his 12th year on the tour. He's been a member since 1999. By far, the most experience of your four finalists today.
And another strike for Mika. Three in a row for the big Finn. Joe Arvine on the road. We head a little further west next week. We're in the Bay Area, Dublin, California, for the one-a-day Earl Anthony Memorial Classic. Live coverage next Sunday, 2 Eastern, on ESPN2. Not ESPN next Sunday, but ESPN2. And then the following Sunday on ESPN, 4 Eastern. It's becoming a Super Bowl Sunday tradition. It's the Chris Paul PBA Celebrity Invitational. Nelly, Lil Wayne, Pete Weber, Norm Duke, Reggie Bush, Wes Malott, Jason Belmonte, all there. Koivuniemi in the fifth, looking for four in a row.
Hambo! Rob, last night Mika told us, quote, if I can go straight tomorrow, nobody will beat me. End quote.
And it wasn't an ego-driven quote either. It was pure fact. Here is Smallwood looking for three in a row, trying to dig himself out of an early hole. Right through the nose.
I like that one off my hand. That's not good.
See, Tom Smallwood's got something written on his left hand. It says BTM. It stands for Be the Man. There it is right there. I'll tell you what, any little thing to help you stay in that frame, I'm all for it.
We talked about Smallwood, the former unemployed auto worker from Michigan. A great little side note to that story. After he won the world championship, he did a 15-hour drive home to Michigan. When he got home at 3 a.m., 4 hours later, at 7:15 in the morning, Inside Edition was waiting. On that drive home, somebody from a GM job bank called him, said, you know, we have some openings. Are you interested? He said, you know, I'm actually going to be okay. Right now, I just won the PBA World Championship. I'll finish it up here in a second. Smallwood in sixth. Drop and give me 10. So he's talking to a lady on the phone from the job bank, and he's explaining what he just did. The lady next to that lady in the phone bank said, I'm sorry, is that Tom Smallwood? I just watched him win the PBA World. So she had a conversation with Smallwood. It was really just an amazing feel-good story, particularly coming during the holiday season, and you and I were getting goosebumps yesterday just reliving it with him, and he was blunt with us. He said, man, it didn't hit me till a couple days later when I finally got a chance to sit back and watch the event again. Here is Mika in command, bottom of the sixth, up 33. And another strike for the big Finn, who's eyeing his third major of his soon-to-be Hall of Fame career. Extra Frame is the PBA's video subscription service for the PBA fan who wants more. It features live streaming coverage of every PBA Tour event. Also features exclusive player interviews, behind-the-scenes action, product reviews, and archived PBA telecasts. Head on over to PBA.com today. Click on the Extra Frame link to sign up. Koivuniemi, after that spare in the first frame, has been nothing but strikes, trying to make it six in a row as we begin the seventh frame.
That means hold. And I'll tell you what, Chris Barnes is a smart man. And last week when he told us that Mika could possibly be bowling better than anybody in the world, Chris obviously knew what he was talking about. Mika proving it right now. 53-pin lead through seven. He's at a 290 pace. If he strikes out, the best Tom Smallwood can shoot, 247.
Smallwood really needs a strike here in the seventh.
And there's his second pair of strikes.
Rob, I think it's real interesting in watching this tournament and this whole tournament coming down to one game, one match. It was such a marathon, but throughout this marathon event, it just seemed like power was everything. We saw Jason Belmonte, the two-hander from Australia, up there. We saw Osku Palerma, the two-handed bowler from Finland. It just seemed like power was everything. Dan McClellan, all these power players. Mika, a mere stroker, is just three frames away from winning another major.
Smallwood will not go down without a fight. This will be his second top five finish of the season, and he's able to apply a little bit of pressure on Koivuniemi.
Mika right now is in the 240s already. Like I said earlier, the best Tom Smallwood can shoot is 247. Right now, all the hard work. Mika is trying to have it pay off. He needs to close this match out with three great shots, 8th, 9th, and 10th frame.
One pin shy of seven strikes in a row. Later tonight here in Vegas, we'll have the Hall of Fame celebration. There's Dale Eagle on the left and Len Nicholson, who will be enshrined tonight. Joining my partner, 13-time titleist, Randy Peterson. Got your speech ready?
Almost.
Way to save it for the end, my friend.
Thank
Boy
you.
Koivuniemi trying to clean this one up in the eighth. And he does. Koivuniemi remains clean here in the title match. And we have just two frames left. $250,000 winner's check on the line. The richest winner's check in PBA history. And Mika asking for... Is he asking for a re-rack? Yes, there it is.
Rob, a strike here. Mika can go nine, spare nine. He will shut out Tom Smallwood.
two of Mika's first three telecasts were majors, and he won them both, but it's been over a decade since he earned major hardware. Back on the strike train.
Yeah, that's huge right there. Mika has struggled over the last couple years. You mentioned his last win coming in 2007. He was forced to do a lot more international bowling than he wanted to. Right now, looking for the richest payday in the history of bowling. $250,000. He is nine spare nine in the 10th frame away from doing just that. Now, Tom Smallwood, he needs to strike out to let Mika know he's still there.
This for four in a row in the bottom of the ninth.
Little right of
nice
target.
Shot. Mm. Anticlimactic.
And Mika can exhale. I mean, what theater Mika Koivuniemi produced for us today. Smallwood trying to clean this one up in the ninth. But the story is Koivuniemi. Great pickup. Wonderful pickup from Smallwood. On Wednesday, February 9th, ABC is really putting on a show. Matthew Perry returns to television in a whole new arena of comedy. ABC's Mr. Sunshine, the season premiere Wednesday, February 9th, after Modern Family on ABC. It's good to see Chandler Bing back in the TV gang. Smallwood in the 10th. And that is all she wrote. Mika Koivuniemi is your TOC champion. And he does it sitting down. And a $250,000 payday for Mika.
Well, and Mika does it because he's just a great, great bowler. He prides himself on making shots. He did just that today.
Koivuniemi steps up to close out in the 10th. But it doesn't matter. He has already won it. We'll hear from the Big Fin when ABC's live coverage of the TOC returns to Las Vegas.
The PBA Tournament of Champions on ABC, brought to you by Lumber Liquidators, hardwood flooring for less. Budweiser, great times are waiting. Grab some buds. The makers of Bear Aspirin, expect wonders. And GoRV, visit GoRVing.com to watch a free video. Go affordably. GoRV.
Title number 9, major number 3 for Mika Koivuniemi, a 269-207 victor over Tom Smallwood. And we go down the lanes. Kimberly standing by with the man who just moments ago lifted the TOC hardware.
Mika, it's been 10 years since you've won a major, but you have back with a vengeance. A 299 you bowled today, one pin shy of getting a 300, and then you win the TOC. What does this day mean to you?
Has to be my greatest day of my life so far, as a bowling wise. That one pin doesn't bother me right now. I want more to win than shoot 300.
Well, congratulations to you. Mika Koivuniemi, our 2011 tournament champion. You are the winner, Rob.
And what a performance he put on for us, Kimberly. A 299 in the semifinal match. 10 strikes in his title match. Rob Stone, Bo Burton, Randy Peterson back here with you. And we'll start with the soon-to-be Hall of Famer. Your thoughts on Mika's performance today?
Well, there's a lot to be said about perseverance. And Mika's worked really hard to get back to this point. And his focus today was just unbelievable. It was really off the charts to shoot 299 and then to follow it back up with that performance there for that kind of pressure, that kind of money, truly spectacular.
And Randy, to follow it up, I think you just called the most memorable game in tournament champion history in the semifinal match, the 299 to 100. That's the best.
Yeah, Tom Daugherty won't want to hear that one too many more times, but he put on great theater for us at the end. Next week, we're in the Bay Area. Mika Koivuniemi and company heading to Dublin
California for the one-a-day Earl Anthony Memorial Classic. Again, that one is going to be on ESPN2 next Sunday at 2 p.m. Eastern. Mika Koivuniemi takes his third major. Stay tuned for ESPN Sports Saturday coming up next, except on the West Coast. For Bo Burton, Kimberly Pressler, Randy Peterson, Bully for Soup, and our entire crew, I'm Rob Stone. Congrats to Mika Koivuniemi. So long from Las Vegas.